And ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of GGR. Well, today we're gonna do a review on this. Yes, it is a laptop or a small tablet PC. This is the Fujitsu Livebook U1010. Okay, it is one of the smaller ranges of PCs that Fujitsu has came up with. And as you can see, it is small. Okay, so I'm just gonna tell you about the exterior of it first, then we're gonna go into the PC itself. Right. So on the outside, you can see here that there are some ports on this side. We have a wireless on-off switch here. We have an SD card reader. We have a volume up, volume down, headphone jacks, and a microphone port there. This is the back with all the serial numbers and stuff. This is the port for something else. I'm not sure. Some connector or something like that. Right, and over here you can insert the wireless card thing. Right, if I'm right, because this is my dad's and I don't use this. Okay, so this is a USB port. There's only one USB port and there's no disk drive integrated into this thing, so which is kinda weird and irritating. It's like the MacBook Air. That's it. Right, there's the on-off switch, so we're gonna hit the on-off switch now. We're gonna switch it on. Okay, it's powering on. Anyway, on the inside, you can see it's a fingerprint sensor over here. We've got function buttons here. Come and get closer. Okay. Function buttons here. This is the mouse track thingy. You have to click, left click and right click. And here we have is a small camera on top. Let's zoom in. Okay, and here we have is our stylus for tablet use. We'll go into that later. Okay, so this thing runs Windows Vista Home Premium. It's Bluetooth integrated, and this is the startup of the computer. Okay, well, first complaint is that it takes kind of long to start up, but oh well, that's kind of like most of the comps these days, and unless you've got a really fast processor in it. And it's really taking quite long. And it's pretty light, actually. Right? It's kind of thin, though. Not as thin as the MacBook Air. And the keys are rather small. Probably my fingers usually hit the wrong keys when I hit them. I usually hit either two at one time or stuff. Not for my sister though. I can try. Yeah, her finger can fit. Right, okay. So here we are in the Windows Vista screen thing. Right, so this is basically what you will get when you buy the PC by itself. Okay, so this thing is a 5.6 inch wide screen, which is kind of a little small. It makes the font look really, really small, and that's probably not a good thing. But considering portability of this device, it is really, really good, and we can bring it around anywhere you go. And the power brick for this is not really that big either. It's like this, as you can see. This charging port goes over here. So just slip this into a bag and, you know, just carry it around. It's not bad. So as you can see, it is still loading. It's not fully loaded yet. It is not working. That is maximum capacity yet. Right, so I've got some of this. Right. So here we are I think it's finally done. It looks done. Let's zoom in. Get a closer look. Okay, so we've got the basic stuff over here. The usual stuff. I'm not sure if we can connect to the internet. I don't think so. Oh, well, it's basically like this though. Wait, hang on, let me... Right. So I'm gonna show you the tablet side of it now. We're gonna turn it like this. I'm gonna push it down. Here it is. It is now a tablet PC. Should be the other way actually. It's still loading really, really slowly. So that's probably one of the low points of the Fujitsu U1010 Lifebook. It loads really slowly. Okay, let's use the stylus and hit it. Okay, this is really irritating. Oh, look. Okay, I think it's... there we go. Here we are in the tablet screen, finally in the tablet screen. So, okay, you've seen for yourself the horrendous waiting time when the U1010 powers up, and you've also seen how small, how compact, and how portable it can be. Not exactly compact, but yeah, how portable it can be when you bring it out and, you know, just go... Well, it came with all these discs, which I think it's pretty useless because you don't have a disc drive to load them in. So you got to buy another external hard disk drive to slot it in from the USB slot here and just load stuff in, which is really, really irritating. And look, the loading time is really, really slow. And then again, there's the complaints with the keypad. Well, this is what you get for probably half the price of the MacBook Air. So maybe if I am, just from my opinion, I would get the MacBook Air. I would actually either work or save up twice as much of the money to buy this to buy the MacBook Air. Both doesn't have a hard drive. That is much thinner and that has a full-sized keyboard and stuff. But this is just... Look, the screen is still upside down if you hadn't realized. I have... placed it back into this laptop position and the icons are still upside down. Look at that. So yeah, you've seen how it impressed us with the smallness, probably, lightness of the thing, and how it pissed us off with its slow loading time and really slow loading time. Small keypads and stuff. So yeah, GGR would give it a 6 out of 10. And oh look, it's finally back upright. Camera woman today was Sabrina. Thank you for watching the review of the Fujitsu Lifebook U1010. For any more videos, go to ggrpodcast.blogspot.com. Thank you. Goodbye.